probably still a little afraid because it hadn't been that long since Jesus rose to new life. But they were still together. The story was still around. People knew that one who had died was now raised to new life. But they were still not sure. Jesus had ascended into the sky before he left, and he told the counselor, that counselor would be the Spirit of God, which would never leave. Spirit would not just rest upon them, but it would move them to do something extraordinary. They would be moved by the Spirit to bring about change in people's lives, to enable sons and daughters to prophesy, to enable visions and dreams to be made, and to enable the wonders of heaven to be seen, even for a short moment. And they would experience something amazing, but they didn't know what or how. But what do we mean for the Spirit to come? So on that festival day, they're gathered together, they're eating and sharing and having a good time. They're gathered together to celebrate. And the Spirit of God comes. Strong winds are blowing. The house is filled with sound and loudness and people. The wind that is the Spirit of God descends those who are there, and then they're able to talk, not to each other, but in languages they've never spoken before. Languages of the many groups of people from around the world who are now outside their door in the streets of Jerusalem. But all those people have gathered to celebrate Pentecost. The people who heard the disciples discussing and talking in different languages saw that what was above them were like balls.
Why not? Now the cow, of course, would have had a good belching.
Spirit of God had done it for them. And they waited the time and waited until it was the proper time to do so. And our story will be next week when Peter addresses the crowd and talks about this. They were afraid of what was going to happen to them after Jesus ascended into heaven. But their lives had been forever changed because of him. And now the Spirit was moving them to do something. But what did this Spirit coming at Pentecost call Christ's disciples to do? Meaning us. What are we supposed to do? Because we too feel the Spirit. We so choose to have that Spirit come in our lives, and in our church, and in our family, church. Well, the Spirit of God calls us to be one in accord. That is to be together, to have similar ideas, to agree on matters regarding God, and to act and to serve Him the best way we know how. We're also called to join together constantly in prayer. No matter where we are, whether two or three gather together, we are to pray to God and give Him the praise and the glory, but also to confess and give thanks and to invite for change and petition. We're also to gather to worship and pray, to worship God, so that we know that God is worthy of our praise. It's not about us. It's about God. Pentecost also marks the birth of the Christian church because Jesus' disciples were now blessed by God's Spirit to carry on Jesus' ministry. The disciples were fully changed because of what happened to them. They had a new direction, and they were moved to begin again. Maybe what we need to happen is to have those strong winds of Pentecost to move us and turn the church upside down so there will be a renewed hope. You might experience will overwhelm you and cause you to become quiet or move you to shout or sing or dance and take delight in God and praise Him. It all depends on how you open your heart to receive. This is what is meant when we say, move in the Spirit. We're doing what God calls us to do. The Spirit calls us, but leads us and guides us to do something a little bit different. You might have a bit of a struggle between head and heart, but the Spirit will make you. gospel of God, we have that fire kindling within us as the Spirit moves us. New hope and new passion. It's coming from God as we become ready to move with the Spirit. It's God's hands. Let us pray. God, every time you feel the Spirit, we get excited. And when you call us to try something new, we say, not yet. Every time we experience your Spirit moving in us, we wonder why now when it is not so easy. Every time we look to your word, your guidance and strength, we think we know what is there. But your Spirit still moves amongst us, and we look to grow.